How has this all been accepted or not accepted by the mainstream economics community?
For me personally, that's a long story.
Yeah.
And, I think all I can do is, I feel strongly personally about it, but rather than go into history, I would simply say that the field of economics has long thought this way, seeing the economy as evolving and complex, but it never was able to mathematize that point of view. So what became accepted as theory in the 20th century was this stasis of equilibrium and all problems being extremely well defined and all the agents in the economy being deductive geniuses who right. could solve these well-defined mathematical problems. Now, with these new tools, we're coming back to an earlier view of economics where it's evolving and changing and perpetually giving new patterns, more like the game of life, if you like, mm-hmm. where you see quite new patterns, and yet these are structures you can isolate and study. Economics is having a bit of a difficult time absorbing this. I would say that people who are middle-aged and trained in the mainstream are intrigued by it, but they're not quite sure whether to accept it or not. People under 30, graduate students, postdocs, are wide open to these ideas, and there's a lot of work getting done on that. Mm-hmm. The other thing I want to point out is that the crash in 2008 helped this point of view enormously.
Right. The old, you had to rethink a lot of sort of truths, quote unquote.
Yeah, that's right. The Economist magazine pointed out that that the U.S. economy wasn't the only victim of the Wall Street meltdown. Neoclassical or standard economics was another victim.
Right.
And I think that's probably too strong a statement, because standard economics will be around for a long time. It's well understood. It may be something of a simplification, but it's kind of benchmark and it works fairly well. After 2008, 2009, though, a lot of the assumptions were questioned, and rightly so. Mm-hmm. People began to say, well, is it true that all these interactions among economic agents, all the little investors are perfectly independent, therefore we get normal distributions and normal deviations as we're in the financial models? Of course, that's not true. And people started to be aware that the financial system was set up in networks of banks and other financial institutions. And if one bank got into trouble, that could affect another bank in the node next to it, which could affect other banks. And so you get propagations of difficulty or propagations of distress
right.
spreading across those networks. So for quite a long time, for the last 5 years, economics has been open to different points of view for the first time, I would say, in decades. One of the interesting points of view is behavioral economics, and that's asking actual people, consumers or people who run companies, what are you likely to do in such and such a situation? Mm-hmm. How would you react in this or that situation? And it's accepting that not all problems in economics are well-defined logical ones.
And that people aren't necessarily rational decision makers, right?
Exactly.
Right.
So we're backing off from those assumptions as well. And so economics, I think, is making major moves to encompass reality.
And
we'll never finally get there, but rather than say imagine a perfect world, where people are perfectly deductive, problems are perfectly defined, everything is perfect, everything's in balance. We're saying imagine an organic world where the types of situations I'm facing are not that well defined. How do people behave and how do they interact? And what sort of patterns would we see? I keep coming back to patterns,
right,
or structures, and I'm sure that's the theme for your course.
Right, well, we talk about sort of emergent phenomenon as being patterns.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. So I'm sitting here in Silicon Valley. I'm in Palo Alto here. And if I work for a high-tech company, which I do, Park, if we launch some product, it's not that well defined. We don't know how the product will work technologically 2 years in advance. We don't know who will enter that space. We don't know what our rivals are going to do. We don't know how the government would regulate this or that. Yet we have to make decisions. So economics is becoming very aware that it's not just solving, consumers or firms are not just solving well-defined problems. The big thing is figuring out what the problem is in the first place, or what the situation is in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
And we can start to think about that and model that as well.
Mm-hmm.
I want to make one other point and say this, that there's an idea out there that complexity economics is really doing economics the same way as before, but doing agent-based modeling and then throwing a computer at all of this.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not the point. The point is to see that agents, the players in the economy, are creating some situation that they may always have to react to.
Mm-hmm.
That changes their behavior again. That changes the situation or the ecology that's mutually created, and they have to re-react. All of that may never settle down and
so
make it perpetual novelty.
Yeah, constantly in a highly dynamic state instead of an equilibrium.
Yes, so we're doing non-equilibrium economics.
Mm-hmm.
And beforehand, a lot of people would have said, well, we can't do that. You know, you can't catch, it's too complicated.
You can't do the math.
Yeah.
Right.
Too complicated to capture in pencil and paper. Maybe, but again, this is like the game of life, or it's like some very fancy or weird cellular automaton. What you can do is study outcomes, look for patterns, isolate the phenomena that you want to see, and then make toy models or make very particular models that you can study, possibly using mathematics, sometimes using the computer.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not just throwing a computer blindly at it and simulating. It's much more using many different tools, including computation, to study phenomena that might arise and then maybe melt away. It's one analogy that fascinates me is that from afar, the sun in the solar system, the sun looks as if it's in equilibrium, you know,
mm-hmm.
92 million miles away or whatever it is. And but if you get up close, or if you look closely at the sun, you see there's all sorts of phenomena happening temporarily.
Right.
There's X-ray bright spots, there's magnetic loops, there's plasma ejections, all kinds of things are bubbling and boiling and going on. Well, the economy behaves like that. Maybe grossly it looks as if it's in some sort of equilibrium, but there's all kinds of bubbling, boiling phenomena in the economy. And as it happens, those are the very phenomena, those are the things that people make money out of. Those are where the investments are going. Those are where the new technologies are launched.
Right.
Those are where
the
all the action is.
The
and that's where all the trouble happens.
Yeah, right.